taking.
Hey, this is Reed Newbert, and in 2015, my wife Lisa and I, and our tandem, flew from Salt Lake City to Munich and rode through some of the most beautiful parts of Bavaria, Tyrol in Austria, and the Dolomites of Northern Italy. This is our adventure.
What you doing there, Lise?
A dry restroom.
Okay. Oh, how's it all fitting?
It all fits. And I have everything packed, basically. So, and it weighs 10 and a half pounds. It'll probably be 11 by the time I get it again.
Uh-huh.
It's heavier this time than last time because there's a lot of rain here. It's really heavy. So. Mm-hmm.
We're hoping to stay dry because
we're
it's supposed to be rainy.
Okay. I think we got it in. And hopefully we got all the tools and everything we need in order to get it put back together when we get to Munich. Not everything's locked in this time. We didn't book all of our hotels in advance. We've got the hotel booked for the first night and the last night, and that's it. And everything else is gonna be, let's just go to the town and see if we can find a cute hotel there to stay in. So anyway, Lisa's been practicing her German. She's gonna be awesome, is gonna help us get out of tight spots. All right, well that's the box and we're packed and hopefully we're ready to go on this trip. Lisa, are we ready?
We're ready.
Okay, here we go.
Bijzonder welkom voor onze Flying Blue leden. Gedurende de hele reis kunt u gebruik maken van kleine elektronische apparaten, smartphones, tablets en e-readers. Met al je elektronische apparatuur met de antenne in airplay mode.
Niet
goed. Hier kan je helpen zien.
Ah ja.
Ah. Alright.
Thank you.
inside. The future never looks so bright. Can't you hear it calling us? Let go.
I don't have to know.
Lisa, what you doing? We just got here, and it's a wall, a dirt road wall, and it's dark, and so we're going to turn around and go back the other way, because this is clearly not a good way to get to Oberammergau in the dark. All right, got our shoes back on, here we go. Where are we going, Lisa?
We're going in the rain to Oberammergau.
Look raining, like you're ready.
But that's why we bought this gear. So we're going to find out how good it is.
This is my biker chick. She's good. Covered from head to toe. Love it. All right, here we go.
our first major climb. We've been climbing 12% for a while. Right now it's 9. When you're in and out of love, let the waves crash in. We're getting closer. We've been a vertical climb. 12% right now. Understand your pain will rain, and it will stay. You get lost. You're taking beautiful pictures. Went the wrong way. And so now it's starting to get dark, but not too bad. We found our trail again. So there's a lot of trails, so we found a trail again that goes to Mittenwald. So here we go. Thank you. Well, it was really windy last night, and it started to rain this morning, so we put on our rain gear. Then we got out to the bike and it wasn't raining, so we took off our rain gear. And now it's still pretty windy, and it's a headwind. Republic Österreich. Tyrol. Here we are, these in Tyrol. Autobahn or something and died. And people were honking at us. Yeah, the arrow likes this. People were honking at us, telling us we were going the wrong way. And so we stopped, we moved over. We were going to go down into a tunnel and in some freeway, anyway, under the mountain or something like that. And people were honking at us to get us to stop. No, go that way!
People were cycling. Stop!
Yeah. So there's like this massive figure eight on my Garmin. Like, I can't tell what the heck that's even saying to do, but we made some guesses. So we turn around again, come back and find the bike path. So now we're on it. After almost getting onto two freeways, we are now on this lovely bike path. Garmin says it's the safest. So off we go. Yep. I am. I hope these don't shock us. Okay. We're on the right road. Run into a cow. Nice cowies. Sleep.
I love this road. This road is delightful. It's taking us through all these little villages. Well, we have ridden 72 miles today, and we have climbed about 3,500 feet, and we're getting tired. Well, we found a wonderful place to stay with an old lady who is so happy to have us and cute as a button. So we just came across the river to get some dinner to this other little town that's on the other side of the river, and then we'll go back. Now this is 7. It's counting down with back.
Oh,
Okay, we're headed out of Glorenza. It's a beautiful morning. We're headed for the Passo Dello Stelvio, right, Lisa?
Yep.
It's gonna be fun, huh?
Yep.
We talked to a guy the other night who said that Lance Armstrong said that this is the hardest climb he's ever done. I'm just trying to get Lisa comfortable.
Thanks, honey.
You're welcome. Since we got the two of us and 30 pounds of luggage. Here we go. Right there. And we're at turn 34. Oh man. I didn't expect an 18. This looks a little steep too. Meters, 9% grade.
Yeah.
You've got 12. Okay. It's up there. Oh, I've got 11 now. 24 switchbacks left. Still more than the entire Alpines. Oh man, that looks so cool. Fifteen hundred feet to the top. A little delirious at this point. We're doing great. I think that up there represents 20 switchbacks. This road is amazing. One other girl on this entire ride. My wife rocked in Bavaria! Hey Lisa!
Hi Reed.
What are we doing?
We are climbing the Stelvio.
Oh my gosh.
Crazy.
This
amazing.
Is crazy.
Beautiful.
I'm trying to get my ear.
Not me.
Okay. That's fine. if I can get inside. Where's the sign? Where's the sign? I want a sign. And they'll go up here. We stayed in Formio last night, had a great night's sleep. Eat pizza. Bump up here. Down the park. Now we're going to the bakery to get some goods. Then we're going to go climb the Stelvio again. Go down the Umbrell Pass into Switzerland. And back over into Italy. So, supposed to be a bakery around this corner here.
headlight on, taillight flashing. It's been much easier today. Traffic's much lighter on this side. This is the less famous climb, because it only has 40 switchbacks and not 48. It's not as pretty for sure, but it's still all the way to the top. Right here, 14%. Well, we dropped our bags off at the Umbrelle Pass, and now we're riding the last 2 kilometers of the Stelvio, so we can exchange Lisa's shirt, which was medium, but she needs a small. Coming up on number 2 here. Oh my goodness. Oh, it's cut yet. Yeah. Okay, now we're going down the Umbrail Pass into Switzerland. We're told this is a fantastic road, and it'll take us right back into Italy.
your love I know that gives me strength.
Drive all night with you right next to me. I wanna go.
feel the pounding of your heartbeat. When we get up high, we won't look down, we won't look back. Yeah, when I die, I wanna know I lived like that. I wanna run in wide spaces, fly like the wind in high places, rushing like water on my face, with your hand in my head.
All right, here we go. We are climbing the Passo Compelongo. Back. Is that what it said? Yeah. I like switchbacks because they actually make it easier. That switchback goes straight up.
Hi, Lisa.
Hi.
Are we having fun?
I am.
Let's see if we can do this.
We should show the cows.
Now we've seen enough cows. Want to see chicks? What are we doing? What are we climbing?
And it's really, yeah.
4 kilometers left. At the top, we visited with this German lady, and she was just blown away that we could ride our bike in this country. She's like, sehr toll, sehr toll. She's like, she's didn't understand how we could do it and thought we were very great, awesome.
Well, Lisa.
Yes.
What are we doing here in this hotel today?
We're gonna just spend time at this hotel in this town today because
supposed to rain at like 2 o'clock this afternoon, 1 to 2 o'clock this afternoon. We're just gonna get on our bikes and hope for the best. So, Lisa? Are we crazy?
I'm wearing everything I got.
All right. It's not quite what we expected. We're hoped for. We're prepared. This morning, we're making a dash for Colo Santa Lucia. We just had some Italians drive past us, stick his bald head out the window, and yell something in Italian. Caicialo! So pump his fist. He was excited to see us. Less than 100 meters to the summit, Lisa. Thank you.
I met him in Bavaria.
Oh, you did?
I did. He was on some computer. He was at pretty much. And then he just drove by and rolled down the window and said, Salt Lake City? I said, yeah.
clouds are lifting, and we are seeing the Dolomites again. Oh, look at that, Lisa. We're gonna stop and take a picture. So I told Lisa, I said, hey, I think around this corner there's going to be a beautiful church. And then there it was. Just to prove that I studied the maps a little bit. Santa Lucia, looked around a little bit and decided to stay there. The view is just heavenly. So now we've ridden back here after having some ice cream. And we're gonna check out this beautiful view again. Just spectacular. All right, Lisa, what are we doing today?
We are going to go back and take some pictures at a overlook. And then we're going to go up the Passo Gal, which is a lovely average of 9 or 10, which means we're going to hit 15s today.
In 10 kilometers, we're going to climb 2,700 feet.
Did you have to tell me that?
Just so that you know.
Just so I can freak out.
And it's right over there, up to the left side of the taller point of that yellow building. Left side of the mountain there. Begins.
dizzy from the way this world is turning, turning. Different from the way our mothers told us. Can't seem to figure out which way is up or down. Can you point me in the right direction now? We're all just trying to find our place, but each day could go a million ways.
Hey Lisa, what are we doing?
Oh, this is awesome. This is the Passo Dello Stelvio. And I wish I could just take a wood shed up here and fix it up and live in it. It's amazing. And there's a ski resort right over there.
Loving the climb?
Loving the climb.
Oh, it's a steepy.
Loving the climb. It's a steepy.
This right here is 12%.
Yeah. For the last hour and a half now.
It is beautiful though, isn't it?
Everybody's looking for the answer, answer. For all the questions they're afraid to ask. Can't seem to pin it down.
We're almost there. Right up there. The summit is for Paul, Tyler, and Matt. No, it's 2 o'clock. This one's for you guys. Got the house. Woo!
We'll shake it up until we figure it all out.
Climb the Passo delle Croci. There it is, Lisa. Passo delle Croci.
Thank you. so bright. Can't you hear it calling us? Let go. Leave all of your cares behind.
You never know where you might find some things coming up.
Dreaming of tomorrow, soaking up the sun. We can sit and talk about it. Oh, we could run. Let's go. Dive into the deep blue sky. Come with me to paradise. Can't you hear it calling us?
Can't you hear it calling us? Calling us.
Dreaming of tomorrow, soaking up the sun. We can go and find the magic. Yeah, we could run.
So I'm just not sure if I should take this picture. Is this a good picture? Come look in the screen with me. Will you take a look at this with me?
Let me look. Hurry, don't waste.
I'm just not sure if that's a good picture. What do you think? I don't know. That?
No. Maybe left. Maybe?
Left a little? How about there?
That's pretty.
What do you think about that?
Maybe left a little.
Right there?
No.
That's got a church in it.
Ooh, it's got
there.
A church.
Oh, yeah, I see that. I like that. That's better. Oh, yeah.
Ooh.
Whoa.
Ooh.
Maybe you should take that.
No. Maybe to the right. Just
to the right, just a bit.
Yeah.
Here, reach up and push that white button.
Okay, white button.
It? Yeah. There we go.
There.
Good job, Lisa.
Can't you hear it calling us? Can't you hear it calling us? Calling us. Dreaming of tomorrow, soaking up the sun. We can go and find the magic. Yeah, we could run away.
Take it.